они не американцы.
Нет, прошу вас! Нет, не надо, не надо! Нет, нет, пожалуйста, нет! Нет! Не надо! Нет, не надо! Нет! Не надо этого! Отпустите меня! Нет, отпустите! Нет! Отпустите! Нет! 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 Выпусти меня! Выпустите меня, пожалуйста! Выпусти!
Я оставлять меня здесь. Я не виновен. Я не виновен. Я не прошу вас.
Welcome back, everyone. It's Charlie. Big surprise, we got an early Stranger Things Season 4 trailer, so we'll break it down. There are a couple big Easter eggs in this, and we know a little bit about what's happening with the Season 4 storyline. I will be doing Stranger Things Season 4 videos, just like I did for Season 3 and Season 2, so if you're new to my channel, be sure to subscribe to get everything. One of the reasons why they're dropping this so early is because they need to start production on Season 4 because the kids are aging up so quickly that within another year or two, they're going to look like the teenagers, so this does seem like it's going to be one of the final seasons of the show. They might do Season 5, but they just signed a new first look deal at Netflix with the Duffer Brothers to develop other shows, so unless they have a big spin-off of Stranger Things planned, it sounds like they're planning on moving away from Stranger Things after they're done with Season 4. But as you see this picture of Hawkins slowly turning into the Upside Down, and then you see the camera pan out a little bit with that Season 4 logo flash up, you see a clock counting down to midnight with the tones starting to chime. That's a reference to the Doomsday Clock, which is all about countdown to total annihilation. That was a term that got used a lot during the Cold War between the Soviet Union and the USA. Obviously, in the context of Stranger Things, it's all about the final battle between Eleven and the Mind Flayer. Will their battle tear apart both dimensions? Mutually assured, telekinetic, psychic destruction. But the trademark upside-down organic material growing over everything, the blue coloration, the tagline, imply that the final battle will take place inside the Upside Down. Even though we've traveled there a couple times and Eleven got trapped there between Season 1 and Season 2, aside from Will being trapped in there for the entirety of Season 1, none of the other characters have spent a really long period inside the Upside Down. They've only been in there briefly. That's why Will has that weird connection to the Mind Flayer. So even though he doesn't have special powers the way that Eleven have special powers, even though technically her powers aren't working right at the end of the season, I'll address that in a second. He does have sort of this precognition for the Mind Flayer coming for them. He knows when it's around or when it's about to attack, and that's really useful when you're trying to avoid or trying to fight it. But because of that scene at the end, the tagline is also a reference to Russia field trip, because I feel like we're all on the same page that the American that the Russian guards are talking about in Kamchatka, Russia, in that secret Russian base is Hopper. And he was somehow captured at the end of the season in that big explosion when everyone actually thought that he died because there was no body. But apparently the reason there was no body is because the Russians captured him when they were trying to escape. There's a lot of missing time in between that explosion when you actually see them walking around looking for bodies and actually trying to find people. The military has since been down there to inspect, but there is a lot of unaccounted for time for those Russians to grab Hopper and get away, or at least the couple that survived the explosion. The brand new white Demogorgon that comes out to eat this Russian prisoner at the end is just more confirmation of that, because how would they get a Demogorgon if they weren't the same Russians from Hawkins?
Hey, Dustin?
Yeah.
How big did you say that Demogorgon was?
Big. 9 feet or so. Why?
Because if you remember, the Russians were secretly trying to open their own gate. There are many places around the world where the barriers between dimensions are weak, but the only people in the world that were actually successfully able to open a portal were the people in Hawkins because of Eleven's accident, because she was so much more powerful than the other psychics that were popping up around the world. So even though it seems like the Doctor and all those people during season one had this very special program, you have to imagine that the Soviets had their exact same group of people that they were testing trying to create their own version of Eleven, but they weren't as successful. That was the whole reason for the Russians to come to Hawkins and secretly build the Starcourt Mall so that it could be cover for them using the Hawkins portal. So if the kids are going to go fight the Mind Flayer on its home turf inside the Upside Down, there are only a couple of places they can use to get to the Upside Down. One, they can go back to Hawkins. Like they say, we're not in Hawkins anymore. Technically, they do have to come back to Hawkins to use the portal at the Hawkins lab. Or if some of them are going to travel to Russia, then Eleven could try to open the Russian portal herself. They were unsuccessful when they tried it themselves, but they didn't have Eleven. And Eleven only accidentally opened the portal for the first time when she was using her power to try and reach someone that was all the way across the world in Russia. They were trying to use her to spy on the Soviets, so they actually have already been to Russia on the TV show. It's just that they haven't used those flashbacks where Eleven is using her mind to reach out to Russia. She might actually be able to see Hopper doing that same trick too. As for Eleven losing her powers at the end of the season, that's just a result of them closing the gate between dimensions. She has sort of this weird link with the Mind Flayer in the Upside Down. So I think that the minute that they open a new portal to the Upside Down, her powers will just automatically turn back on. And then when they defeat the Mind Flayer inevitably at the end of the season, then her powers might permanently go away. Talking about big ideas, hero's journey, Eleven will have to sacrifice something in order to defeat the Mind Flayer. And usually that means sacrificing your life, but I think the whole idea of the show, it's a little more hopeful. It actually wants Eleven to get the things that she wants for herself. She wants a normal life, so what would she sacrifice? She would probably sacrifice her powers in order to defeat the Mind Flayer. So early prediction, they're successful in defeating the Mind Flayer at the end of the season. Then her true reward at the end of the season is getting to live that normal life that she's always wanted. I haven't heard anything about spinoffs. Yes, they could drag this out to season 5, but I don't know, like the kids are just getting so old. Look at how much different they look between season 2 and the 2-year time jump that it took to get season 3 episodes. When they went on that great break and they had to sign all those new deals and pay all this extra money, all the kids got giant pay raises. There was talk of doing seasons 3 and 4 back to back to avoid any potential delays and issues that would require them to use de-aging technology to make the kids look younger. If you saw the It movie and then It Chapter 2, they actually had to do that with some of those kids. They had to de-age the kids when they got to It Chapter 2 because 2 years had gone by when they started filming it. So they looked way, way older than they did during It Chapter 1, and the flashbacks were supposed to be to that time period. So there was all these continuity issues. So that's why you try to move really fast on new seasons when you have child actors. Pretty safe bet that they're going to drop season 4 episodes 4th of July weekend next year, just like they did this year. They really like that summer holiday weekend. In related Netflix news, the Witcher series with Henry Cavill is premiering later this year. They have not given us a hard premiere date, but the rumor is that it's going to be around Christmas time in December. So even though New York Comic Con is coming up, they haven't said whether or not they're going to drop a new trailer for that, but I will be doing Witcher Netflix videos, so leave all your requests in the comments below. While you wait for everything, click here for the Witcher Netflix trailer and click here for the brand new Rick and Morty season 4 teaser trailer. Thank you so much for watching. Everybody stay awesome. I'll see you guys tonight.